This is But Why, a show for curious kids with me, Jane Lindholm. You ask the questions and we find the answers.
Why do horses have hooves?
So you want to know about hooves, eh? Actually, me too. Good question. So I'm here with somebody who can help us answer that question. Harry Russell in Hinesburg, Vermont. Hi, Harry.
Hey. Hi, Jane.
And we're also joined by two beings who have hooves with us. So there's eight hooves here with us, Harry.
There is.
Who are these friends?
This is Jackson, who's looking behind him. He is going to be 17. And this is Belle, who is going to be 21.
And both of them obviously have hooves because they are horses. And when you think of hooves, you could kind of think of them like toenails and shoes combined. And the actual outside of the horse's hoof is made of keratin. And you have keratin in your own body, including in your fingernails. So it's kind of the same material, but a lot more of it in the horse's hoof. Can we look at their hooves, Harry?
We can.
All right, let's take a look.
They're kind of muddy because they've been in the mud walking up here. But their leg comes down, and they have fur right down to the top of the hoof. It's kind of covered in mud. But this part all around here is the hoof. And this little silver part right here is part of the shoe that's nailed onto the bottom of their hoof.
So if you've ever heard of a horseshoe, it's a real thing. Horses wear shoes sometimes. Why do you put a shoe on them?
It is almost entirely for better traction, because the shoes have nubs on the bottom of them, and so when it's icy or when it's muddy, it helps keep them from slipping as much.
Does it help if they're walking on uneven ground? Like, I would want to wear shoes so that if I'm walking on rocks, it doesn't hurt my feet as much.
Yeah. The shoe is maybe 3/8 of an inch thick, so it holds the bottom of the hoof up off the ground, and so like small pebbles or things wouldn't be pressing into the soft part of their foot.
Now, when you're putting shoes on a horse, I mentioned the part of the hoof that is on the outside is made of keratin, same as our fingernails. Mm-hmm. Now, we all know we have to clip our fingernails.
Yeah.
Some people chew their fingernails,
yes,
but we're supposed to clip them. Do horse hooves continue to grow like that too?
They are growing all the time. And horses, like in the wild, they would be probably a lot more active than these horses and running, and they would tend to keep them worn down. If they got too long, they might tend to break off, but either way, they're kind of wearing them away. With ours, they get trimmed. We actually cut the shell of the hoof that's growing several times a year just to kind of keep them smooth and try to discourage the breaking, because sometimes they break and it's uneven.
Now, there are other parts of a horse's hoof, and including a sole. You have a sole of your foot, but you put weight on the sole of your foot. The horse doesn't bear weight on its sole, but it does bear weight on a part of the foot that's kind of got a cool name. It's called the frog. And the frog is kind of like a shock absorber in your car. So when the horse is walking, the frog takes the shock from all of that pounding that the horses may be doing, especially if they're carrying heavy loads or carrying a person.
Yes.
Well, Jackson and Belle, maybe we'll let you get back to eating apples and carrots. Thank you for talking with us today, and thank you, Harry.
Yes, thank you.
To find out more about But Why and listen to full podcast episodes, go to butwhykids.org.